Hello. I feel weird speaking into a microphone for like 5 people, but this is fun. We're going to get started. I know there are more people in the building somewhere, and they'll meander over back. So thank you so much for being here. You know all of us. I'm not going to go ahead and introduce us. We're going to start with a poem by composer Pauline Oliveros, and so her whole process is the concept of deep listening, and so this whole recital is inspired by that. So everything is music, hence the menagerie of the situation over here. And the poem is called The Earthworm Also Sings. It's a composer's guide to deep listening. So so I guess we'll get started. I'm gonna flip to the page. I'm gonna adjust this. You ready? I hear, I am, I receive what is, listening, no argument. My body is sound, listening guides my body. Sound is the fiber of my being and of all sentient beings without exception. Is sound intelligence? The earth is also sound, guided by sound, and so are all things of the earth. Rocks are her ears, recording all of her events from the beginning. My earth body returns to hers, where the earthworm also sings. Inside, outside vibrations. My bones resonate. My stomach, spleen, liver, kidneys, lungs, and heart resonate. These organs are sound, contain sound. The rhythms of my bodily life encoded in the theater of my mother's womb, I listen from the beginning. Universal process, cellular language, familiar to all sentient beings without exception. Only deep listening returns me to this infinite source of all beginning. Abundance, cocooned creativity, brilliant spark, sounding pulse, life unending. Beauty of fading physical being toward that special mysterious silence, zero vibrations. Never zero in this life until the bones disappear. The process of dying, also sound, sound of becoming another kind of being. Living dying, pulsing dying, listening to death, returning to home in the earth where the earthworm also sings, shedding physical body like the earless snake shedding skin, allowing spirit body to soar at home in the universe. Gathering, learning through hearing what is inside, outside space. Learning zero vibration is not absolute. Learning there is always living, dying, sound leading me deeper. Learning I was born here to hear all my cells through my cells. Each cell singing the song of its structure. Space dance of creation and an architecture of sound. I am a community of musical cells. The dance inside, outside. The sound is the dance, is the sound. Space in the sound dance is silence. Space silence is the resting place of all sentient beings without exception. Inside, outside, space silence heard, unheard, felt, unfelt. Playful universe. Inside, outside, the most special pleasure, sound pleasure. Listening from the stomach, I satisfy hunger and reject that which would harm me. Listening from the liver, I purify what I have ingested. Listening from the kidneys, I discard what I don't need. Listening from the spleen, I redden my blood and increase my courage. Listening from the lungs, I sustain my life. I breathe and change my emotions. Listening from the heart, I open to life. Says Master T.K. Shi, the ocean is big, but the heart is biggest. The heart has ears for the pathway. receiving, my ear also sounds. Where are the receivers for these tiny mysterious signals? Inside? Outside? The cells? In my oralizations, I hear an alternate self, tiny enough to journey inside of my own ear. In this pleasure of the imagination, I go into the labyrinthine cave. Following the sound pathways, I wobble in full resonance with the mammoth vibration of the tympanic membrane. On the sound wave, I ride through the shuddering porous membrane, teetering, tottering, balancing with the undulating phenomenon. Adventure. On the other side, I narrowly escape the pounding hammer as it thumps the anvil. Thrilling, I glide through the oscillating archways of the stirrups. Plunged into the spiraling fluid of the inner ear, I float marveling at the fleeting echoes in the bony chambers of the seashell-like cochlea. The journey accelerates as I am swung into space by a quickening neuron. Weightless, I experience a celestial calm, accompanied by the tiniest pings and pongs of a rippling, subtle harmonic drone, making the most comforting music. Traveling simultaneously fast yet slow, my still yet moving alternate body sings a wordless and wondrous song in the company of my multitudinous self. Let us now question the question, what does the ear want to hear? What is there to want when what is, and will always be? I hear, I am, I receive what is, listening, no argument, spark bright, sounding, pulse energetic, fade out beautiful, dying am I living? Living am I dying? Returning to where the earthworm also sings, deepest listening is for that which has not yet sounded, receiving that which is most unfamiliar, learning its space-time silence, sound, dance, interacting with that which is most familiar, listening until the newest is learned, making space for the yet unborn through sight stillness, stillness where the subtlest motion dances so swiftly that perception comes to the tiniest possible point, disappearance, void, fast, slow, vast heart opens, this is where love is, all time is present. I wake up from this dream in the joy of being. Quietly, I return as my streaming body finds present moment here with you. Hearing, listening with you, grounding with you, sounding, becoming silent or relatively so. In silence, I am deepest thought. Einstein did not speak until he was four. We know that he was listening. What was he hearing?
Thank you, guys.
So that poem. She's best friends with John Cage, and so and if you know a little bit about them, they were both really inspired by Buddhist thought and Buddhist ideals, and you can hear that throughout that piece. And it was written as a response to an essay called "I Hear Therefore I Am," which is essentially it, right? That's the core of everything, you know? That's what music is. If you don't hear it, it's not music, right? If you're not listening. So thank you all for being here tonight. So next we're gonna transition into some more Bach, and it'll be fun. I'm gonna play the Prelude from the third Bach Cello Suite. So, in C major.
Thank you.
pieces were written in churches and in large spaces like this, so I'm really happy to get to perform it in such a large space because it kind of, it like washes over you in a way, that piece. So next we're gonna do a little bit more poetry, a little bit more improvisation. I and Quincy and Max are gonna play a lovely piece also, so I'll just get started. This next poem is by Joy Harjo. She's from Tulsa, Oklahoma, which is, not from Tulsa, you're from Tulsa. she's from the Muscogee Nation, and a lot of her work is inspired by the earth around us and nature around us, and so I felt it fit the theme of tonight. So. This first poem is called Cricket Song, and then the second poem is called Speaking Tree. So, a lot of that. So, okay, you ready? Okay. Tonight I catch a cricket song, sung by a cricket who wants the attention of another. My thinking slides in the wake of the cricket's sweet longing. It's lit by the full moon as it makes a path over the slick grass at the widest dark. I doubt the cricket cares his singing is swinging starlight to the worry that has darkened my mind. It is mating season. They will find their way to each other by sound. Time and how are the mysterious elements of any life. I will find my way home to you. Speaking Tree by Joy Harjo. Also, that would be a cool surprise. That would be amazing. I had a beautiful dream. I was dancing with a tree, but sand versus arrows. Some things on this earth are unspeakable. Genealogy of the broken. A shy wind threading leaves after a massacre. Or the smell of coffee and no one there. Some humans say trees are not sentient beings, but they do not understand poetry. Nor can they hear the singing of trees when they are fed by wind or water music, or hear their cries of anguish when they are broken and bereft. Now I am a woman longing to be a tree, planted in a moist, dark earth between sunrise and sunset. I cannot walk through all realms. I carry a yearning I cannot bear alone in the dark. What shall I do with all this heartache? The deepest rooted dream of a tree is to walk, even just a little ways, from the place next to the doorway to the edge of the river of life and drink. I have heard trees talking long after the sun has gone down. Imagine what it would be like to dance close together in this land of water and knowledge, to drink deep what is undrinkable. Right. Okay, so Postlude by Gigue Cummings. Life is more true than reason will deceive. More secret or than madness did reveal. Deeper is life than leaves. Higher than have. For beauty is more each than living's all. Multiply the infinity, sons, if the mightiest meditations of mankind canceled are by one merely opening leaf. Beyond whose nearness there is no beyond. Or does some littler bird than eyes can learn look up to silence and completely sing? Futures are obsolete, pasts are unborn. Here, less than nothings, more than everything. Death, as men call them, ends what they call men. But beauty is more now than dying is when.
Thank you.